Good morning to all. Today I'll be talking about the business model in CGT. You may be knowing that new business models have come into existence where the private parties can take part in CNG station development. We have taught you that there are four types of CNG station which are there. They are the CNG station which are called the mother CNG station, the CNG station which are called the online CNG station, we have the daughter CNG station and daughter booster CNG station. We also told that this is the time of hybridization and the input to CNG is not only natural gas but also the LNG. So we have stations which are called LCNG. And we have seen in case of LCNG also, there are stationary stations, there are mobile stations. Now we have known in our previous classes that in the CNG station, the mother station is having stationary cascades. The filling of the CNG is through stationary cascades. Whereas in the daughter station, there are mobile cascades. The mother CNG station has to be near the highways. It has an implication in the models which I will be talking about. Mixed type of CNG station like the ACNG and LCNG are also in vogue and has been given cognizance under these three models. You have been knowing that Bharat Petroleum is working for the models which I am talking about. Today CNG is coming at rupees 44 per kg and it is an important aspect as far as filling the cars and the vehicles are concerned. We have seen that the light commercial vehicles and the heavy commercial vehicles are filled to CNG and the fillings are time fill and fast fill. Now many cars require fast filling where the time taken is less. If you have time and it is a high commercial vehicle, then you can keep that vehicle in the CNG station for a longer time in the night and it will be filled. We have talked about Joule Thomson cooling effect and we know it has bearing in filling the CNG tank. When the models has to be decided for CGT, couple of things I would like to make you aware that why is CGT profitable today? Because the factors which influence the market is favorable. You know CGD has got a cognizance over fertilizer, power, urea, and it has been mandated that 100% of the gas should go to CGD, and if there is a plus minus 10% variability, that should be filled by GAIL. So CGD has a cognizance in the market, and that is the reason we would go to the gas appliances more, and by 2030 we should see that from the 6% in the energy basket of the gas it should go to 15 to 16%. So understanding the models or the business models is very important, and public private understanding and the models which are the PPP models are important to understand. The policies are favorable. You have seen that the bidding criteria have changed in the 9th and 10th bidding round, and cognizance has been given to many parameters. Improvements are still in process. The smart cities are getting developed, and also the availability of pipeline and other infrastructures in the area which are growing are also developing. You may be knowing that 44 CGD geographical areas have been identified and very shortly the 11th bidding round will be coming. In order to make it profitable, the CNG station need to be developed. And who can build the CNG station? There are three models which are proposed today. One is called the COCO model, which is the company owned and company operated model. The second one is called the CODO model, which is the company owned and dealer operated model. And the third model, which is a very ambitious model, is a dealer operated and dealer owned model. All the three models can work in public private partnership. But to start with, public partnership is important because that gives cognizance and helps in getting third party clearances. In these models, the land is very important. From where we can get the land is also important. So in my next part of the talk, I'll be talking about the matrices which need to fulfill in order to sustain in this model. Thank you very much. So when we talk about the company owned and company operated, company owned and dealer operated, and dealer operated and dealer owned, some of the criteria has to be fulfilled. Now if you see the advertisement where the eligibility and criteria is given, and on the white papers on which we have worked, I can give you a gist what should be the attributes be. Anybody who is applying for these models or will be participate in this type of bids, they have to be at least 10 pass qualified. They should have a land of their own which should have proper clearance. The land on which the CNG station will be developed should be rectangular in nature as far as possible. This land should be a free land and should be leveled properly till the highway. The land is preferable close to the highway, as we have told that the mother CNG station should be close to the highway, so that the vehicles which are going through the highway can stand in the CNG station to get filled. And the filling of the CNG station are through stationary cascade. So the ingress into this land should be minimum, the incumbency should be minimum, and it should be a non-agricultural land. If this land is an agricultural land, it has to be converted into a non-agricultural land and all clearance should be taken before. The land can be given to the company on a long-term lease, or the company can own the land. In this process, the land will be utilized for developing the CNG station. No heavy electric wire of 11 kilovolt ampere or more than that should be passing over this land, and as far as possible the water lines, the telephone lines should be at the periphery and should be excavated in such a way that all the clearance goes in one go. So there should be a multiple clearance available for this land. Now when the CNG station is developed, it should be at the center of the land, and on the peripheries we should have the pipelines. We should also keep in mind that the CNG station should be only one storied, that is ground story building, and there should be safety equipments and glassware present in the CNG station in case of emergency. For emergency, you should have an ERDMP plan for these models, which is given in details in these documents. Once you have a feasibility report as far as the clearance is concerned, as far as non-agricultural land is concerned, or an agricultural land which has been converted into a non-agricultural land, you get a clearance to start building your CNG station. Now in this CNG station, along with the CNG station, to make people comfortable who are passing through the roads close by, maybe the national highways, you can keep a cafeteria or take away close to it, maybe a coffee shop. So that both the purpose is solved. You get your vehicle filled, it will take some time, and the business, which is the secondary business, can thrive on the CNG business. Initially, for 1 year, you should have a mother CNG station, and over a period of time, you can have hybrid CNG station, which is an LCNG station, at least thriving with a plan for next 5 years. Now, the mandate says and the white paper says that it can be of A type, B type or C type LCNG station, which is possible. As you know, that 51% of the intake into the CGD sector is from LNG and the balance is from natural gas, which governments want to make 50-50 over a period of time. LNG requirement into the CNG station will improve day by day. So we should be prepared for that. We can also have a hybrid type of ACNG station in these places, but that should only start from the second year as an augmentation to the mother CNG station from the second to fifth year. A second feasibility study by drones will be done by the authority at the end of the fifth year to see whether all the compliances which has been assured by this organization are taking place or not. Over a period of time, they will decide that from 5 years to 10 years whether this CNG station will be profitable. So a feasibility report at the end of the 5th year is also very important to work upon to see whether the Coco-Dodo and the Kodo models are working. Now the dealer-owned, dealer-operated model has another attribute. In this case, it is seen that not a single piece of land is utilized. There are many lands which are contiguous and are operated by many dealers. They have to work together and they have to prepare a power of attorney for one of the owners, and the power of attorney will be working for this model. So this model is little different than the Kodo and Coco model, where we try to get one single piece of land. But for the Dodo model, we can have contiguous lands which can be attached together. If it is an agricultural land, all the non-agricultural, all the lands has to be converted into non-agricultural land, and this single piece of rectangular land should have one power of attorney. That is all about the business models which are thriving in the CNG station.